Drink too much. I'll give it all that I have, hoping this time it might be enough. Till they pack up my guitars and unplug my star. Oh, a ringmaster's night gets long. I'm back on stage, and it's scary sometimes what I will do to pass them away. Somebody when the circus leaves town. Right now, Hereford Whiteface Sports on KPAN with the five-time state champion Lady Whiteface volleyball team. This match is brought to you by First Financial Bank, Amarillo College, Gooden Fuels, First Bank Southwest, Prairie Insurance, Hereford Regional Medical Center, your Hereford McDonald's, Happy State Bank, Hereford Independent School District, Stevens Five-Star Car and Truck Center, First National Bank, Bob's Heating and Air, WT Services, Deaf Smith County Farm Bureau Insurance, Hereford Texas Federal Credit Union, Mendez & Mullins Family Funeral Home, Hereford Furniture Exchange, Capital Farm Credit, and Matt Silva State Farm Insurance.
Everyone, and welcome to Whiteface Gym. Tom and Brenda with you here this afternoon as we bring you Whiteface Volleyball. The Lady Whiteface is in game number two of district play against the Lady Bulldogs of Borger here on this Tuesday night. And the Lady Whitefaces victorious on Saturday up in Perryton, but coming home here tonight, Coach, to play a very good Borger team.
Yep, it is a very good Borger team, and much improved over what we've seen the last couple of years, although they took us, what was it, 22, 24?
Yeah.
Anyway, they took us real close in one of the sets last year at home, in fact. So it is certainly not a team that you can take for granted, and but no team in our district you can take for granted.
Yep, they lost the open district against the defending state champ Lady Raiders and lost, but didn't play badly. And again, the Lady Raiders went 16-0 last year and probably have a chance to do that again this year. 14-0 in the district, I guess.
I think they last do. Year. They've got Miss Go coming back, and
yeah.
She is just their all everything player, and I've seen a little bit of video of her and hitting from the outside, and I'm telling you, she is a beast out there.
She is, and of course their setter is not bad herself.
No.
She's pretty special. So they. They'll be tough for any of us in the district to unseed, but the Whitefaces, this is one here tonight you got to have. You got to win, your home matches, particularly against the teams that the three Canyon teams, Canyon High, West Plains, and Randall, all going to be difficult outs.
Absolutely, they will be. Looking at Borger warming up here, I'm kind of impressed with their size. Their JV was a big
for
a JV squad, and these guys for varsity, they're hitting out of their right side with some really good size right side blockers.
They are indeed, and we'll see how all this plays out. But as Brenda said, last year they played us pretty darn tough here at home, and so I'm sure they're kind of loaded for bear here tonight too, thinking they won the freshman and the JV, and I'm sure they're here thinking we'll just make a clean sweep of this thing. Well, the Whitefaces will take their swings here in just a minute. Coach Carla McCracken, the head lady, and we'll be back to talk about these Whiteface volleyballers and the upcoming match in 60 seconds.
Start here, AC. Go anywhere. I wanted to be a nurse for years. Amarillo College helped me get there. I had a job lined up even before I graduated. With my degree from AC, I can go anywhere and do anything.
Trust your future to a college that cares.
Start here.
AC. Go anywhere.
Your business, farm, or ranch and home is unique. And success depends in part on a cost-effective and convenient supply of quality fuel. When you trust your fueling needs to Gooden Fuels, it's one less detail for you to manage. Commercial fuel in bulk, delivered to your above or below ground tank, serving the Western Texas Panhandle with gasoline, diesel, and propane. Gooden Fuels in Hereford at 806-364-3366. Call them today to discuss your fuel needs.
Tom and Brenda back courtside here at the Whiteface Gym. Big crowd on the end here tonight. I have never liked watching other teams warm up, particularly other teams that are reasonably good or look good. And I tell you, Borger looks, they look very good.
They are hitting well.
Yep. And they've got a couple of six-footers, maybe 6 foot plus in one instance, I'd say. And so the Lady Whitefaces are going to have their work cut out for them here tonight. Borger's 14-10, and they did not play the Sisters of the Poor. I saw some of their scores against other teams. They played some pretty tough teams in non-conference play. So we got to get ready.
Yeah, we do. And our biggest enemy right now would be just a complacency. Oh, yeah. We've beaten Borger over these last years, and that is always a very frightening concern for coaches, and anybody who's a fan of the Lady Whitefaces. You just can't step into this thinking that way. Looking at them warm up too, I mean, they're running a lot of fast offensive type sets too, which I hope we're prepared for. Yeah. Where Borger has been sometimes a little bit vanilla
tentative
in their offense.
Yeah.
They are not right now as they warm up.
Well, the Whitefaces will get their swings here in a minute. We've got, of course, later this week, Friday, we've got Whiteface football as the Whitefaces 3-0 now. Travel over to Amarillo to face a mighty foe, the 5A Tascosa Rebels. And so we'll have our work cut out, but a great start for the Whiteface guys. Well, they did a superb job Friday night in kind of enemy territory with things not always going our way.
Well, I tell you, congrats to those guys. That has been fun to watch them and how they've handled things. And when they had a little bit of a struggle in the last year or two, and to watch them come out and not get satisfied very early on with a win or with the second win. And golly, that's cool. That's fun stuff.
It really is. They've been most impressive. Saturday we've got more volleyball. Lady Whitefaces travel on Saturday over to Pampa for the third district match. Again, there's 14 district volleyball and basketball matches or games, whichever the case may be, in our district now. And so it has gotten pretty tough.
Absolutely it is. We've got tennis playing right now out at the Whiteface courts. Tennis courts playing Canyon, and those are the two unbeatens at this point. So it's a good match. Last I heard, it was 4-4. So.
Wow. Well, the tennis has been most impressive. Can't say enough about those guys and gals, and of course cross country going on now too. I think we went to Lovington, I believe, this past weekend.
We did. Went to Lovington, and we're going to go down to Lovejoy. So if
Lovejoy,
you got love in the name, we're coming to run there.
Well, that's good. That's good. Lovejoy didn't even exist 10 years ago, and now they're a 5A or 6A, whatever they may be, a big school in any event. Lady Whitefaces taking their swings right now. London Baker, the setter for the Whitefaces. We've got three seniors, Cameron Blair, Allie Purcella, and Emily Alvarado. And then we're pretty young, and our JV is young, so there's a lot of youth having to learn under fire here. And again, the district is as good as any district in the state.
Yep, I would agree. You got the district champ from last year in this district, and they don't get as good as they are and stay good from just their preseason.
Right.
You got to have a pretty tough district season as well, so you're prepared for the playoffs, and it's a tough district it is indeed.
Whiteface is taking their swings at the moment. We're going to take a break for 60 seconds, and we'll return to the Whiteface Gym in 1 minute.
For generations, First Bank Southwest has been there to help the working hands that have shaped this great land. Chances are we helped your father, and even his father. We understand for some, a handshake is a stronger bond than a piece of paper. And even though times can be tough, folks around here are tougher. And that's why we're as proud of our Panhandle roots as you are. First Bank Southwest, moving your generation in the right direction. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Hereford Regional Medical Center is always working to expand our services to better serve the community and is looking for great people to add to the HRMC family. We're hiring for a variety of positions, including clinical roles and non-clinical roles, such as housekeeping and administrative positions. See our open positions at dschd.org/careers and apply today. HRMC is an equal opportunity employer.
All right, back courtside, Whiteface is just about to finish up. We're about to serve one to another. The rest of the Whiteface roster, the juniors, are London Baker, Maddie Madrigal, Stephanie Solorizano, Myra Villarreal, Charisma Trevino, Janae Fletcher, and Cambry Smith. Then we've got sophomores, Lexi Vallejo, and Samantha Grajeda. And then there is a lone freshman, Tegan Thomas, up on the varsity this season. Again, the Whiteface is just about through with their warm-ups. Big, big crowd here at the gym, I'm telling you. I never cease to be amazed at how faithful the fans are here, Coach.
And we have had great crowds every time we've been at home. And we haven't had a lot of home games, so it's kind of nice. We're getting the routines for district of being here, being at home every Tuesday night or every Tuesday afternoon and evening. So that's going to be cool. But, yeah, they have come out when we've had our home matches. They've come out and been great support.
So Lexi Scombato's mom and dad a little bit ago coming in the gym. Of course, they've not only got a player, but they have an assistant coach now. As Alyssa is one of the Whiteface coaches. She just graduated yesterday, I believe, and she became one of the assistants this year. She and Isaiah Valdez, both homegrown coaches for Coach McCracken. So we're surely glad to have them on the staff. And this volleyball season, again, it's going to be hard. It's going to be difficult for the Whitefaces. You know, we've been at the top for so long, and when we're maybe not quite as strong as we have been, it kind of gives other teams a little bit of a boost there too.
Oh yeah, they love to come in and do nothing more but sneak away with a victory,
yep.
Especially on your home on your opponent's home court. So heck yeah, that's been something that Lady Whitefaces have had to work at for a long time, is how to play with a target on your back and remain successful.
We've got some of our athletes dressed in T-shirt, wife beater shirts, I should say, with America written across their chest here tonight, as 9/11, of course, just yesterday. And the guys, I'll tell you, some of them are football players, and they need to have pads on at all times. I mean, they're not, boy, they play well, but they are not large in size. So, good turnout of student body and the rest of the folks here tonight to see the Whitefaces play some volleyball. Two teams have served one another. We'll have the national anthem and a couple of other things take place here, introduction of the teams and all that. And then we'll get to play here at Whiteface Gym on this Tuesday evening, the Lady Whitefaces and the Lady Bulldogs. Officials are ready to go.
Linesman's on
okay.
his way.
Yep. We are set to go here just pretty near set to go at Whiteface Gym. Again, the introductions and the national anthem and so forth and so on has to take place. But Whiteface is in black, solid black tonight with white trim. I saw Cameron's grandparents. The Blairs were here a moment ago.
Between the Borger Lady Bulldogs and your Lady Whitefaces.
Claudia on the PA here tonight. Let's take a break for 60 seconds, and let's make it a minute and a half, Daniel. We'll be back at Whiteface Gym in a minute 30.
When life's unexpected moments happen, you can rest easy knowing Prairie Insurance is on your side. Prairie Insurance will listen to you and help tailor a policy to meet your needs. They offer multiple insurance products, including home, auto, business, and farm insurance, with the knowledge to make sure you're covered. Give them a call at 363-6489 or stop by their office at 213 West Park Avenue. When you're ready to have peace of mind regarding the things that matter most, call Prairie Insurance at 363-6489 or stop by 213 West Park Avenue, and they'll make sure you're covered.
First Financial Bank knows how important a person's vehicle can be.
My SUV is perfect for taking clients to properties and me to the golf course.
My pickup hauls work supplies all week and the family on weekends.
My hybrid helps the environment and my fuel bill.
If you're ready for a new vehicle, talk to First Financial. We offer loans at competitive rates with fast local approval.
My 4x4 works hard, but plays even harder.
First Financial Bank. You first. Member FDIC.
Needing extra income? Looking for a full-time job with advancement opportunities? McDonald's in Hereford is hiring full-time and part-time people who are energetic and customer-focused. At McDonald's, you will be able to work flexible hours, whether it's 3 hours or 8 hours per day. Benefits include a free meal when you're working and a 30% discount when you're off-duty. Earn a vacation benefit and $10 an hour and above with experience. To apply, just text TX162 to 38000.
All right, back at Whiteface Gym. They're about to introduce the squads here as we move closer to start time. Best 3 out of 5, as you know, played at 25. As Claudia gets ready to introduce the teams.
She was reading a little announcement. UAL, I should say UAL, in conjunction with the Texas Association of Sports Officials, has kind of joined together and now there are a little bit stricter standards if fans, coaches, administration, anybody is verbally abusive of officials, that could get our school in trouble. And so we are just encouraging good sportsmanship before we start playing any match.
Well, that's a good idea, and certainly in this day and time, things can get out of hand, especially in a gymnasium, it seems, too quickly. Now Claudia about to introduce the Lady Whitefaces.
Number one.
All the faithful from years gone by, as I look up in the stands, people who have been at these matches for as long as I can remember in some instances are up in the stands cheering for the Whitefaces here tonight. They've seen lots and lots of volleyball matches and some really good times, some disappointing times. But, my gosh, Lexi Vallejo just threw her volleyball.
We need to set her first thing off tonight, don't we?
She threw that thing about the length of the gym and up at the top of the stands. I'm sure that's where the Vallejo family is about 500 in number when they get here. So. Good to have folks. Pete Madrigal sitting over there across the way among the Whiteface faithful. Two teams at the net again. Big size advantage for Borger here tonight.
Yeah, it is. And we haven't said that in a long time.
Nope. Sure enough. Miranda Umstead over there with she and Sonny's newest. Sonny's got the older daughter, and Miranda with the little one.
Amen,
she's done a great job with the cheerleaders here.
Sure
cheerleaders
is.
Really, really do an excellent job. We're ready to play. The Whiteface is pretty pumped up here. We're going to have out on the floor to begin this thing, Madrigal along with Blair and Villarreal. up on the front, Fletcher and Purcella and Baker. Baker will actually, Borger on the other side's got Quinones back at the service line to start this thing. Again, best three out of five, the Whitefaces and the Lady Bulldogs. Tina Sims, the head coach of Borger, Carly McCracken for the Lady Whitefaces. Official throws the ball in, and here we go. First serve of the match now from Quinones comes to the Whitefaces. This play is underway. Nice pass set here at the near side. Alley blocked, but it falls on Borger's side. 1-0 Whitefaces. Alley's really come on. She's been a really outstanding player for the Whitefaces.
Yeah, she loves that strong side too. She oftentimes played the middle of her younger years, but gets to play outside now.
Baker with a good serve, battle at the net. Borger gets it over. Free ball here. We've got a whistle. Borger.
Center was above the
net.
He was a basketball player.
2-0 Hereford. Whitefaces on top here, early going now as Baker serves again. London again, a junior. Her third year to start for the Whitefaces. She's ready to go. The officials now, the Borger coach with a question for the call, but we're ready to go now as the whistle sounds, and here we go. London jump serves, deep, too deep, 2-1. First service error of the match. Whitefaces up 2-1 here in the opening set. Borger ready to serve, and for the Bulldogs, it'll be Pettit at the service line. She's a sophomore. Her service is out, and it's 3-1 as she tried to cut that one to the far side, cut it too wide. Alley comes out. In for the Whitefaces comes Solarizano. Again, she's a junior. She'll serve from the middle. Jumps and serves to the middle. Borger with a good pass on the net. Tips it over. Whitefaces fisted up. Nice save by Kendall. We'll just free ball it back. Borger with a chance here. Lady Bulldogs pass it to the net. We block it. Bulldogs back deep. Now get it back over. Whitefaces tip it over. Blair, nice play by Blair. And the Whitefaces lead it 4-1.
Yep, set coming to the outside was pretty flat, so Kendall did a nice job of getting to it. A little delay tip over the block.
Solarizano with the serve. Borger near side tips, picked up by Solarizano. Played back near side to Kendall, and she hits it long. It's 4-2. Got a good swing here on the near side, but just had a little too much air under it. 2-4. Whitefaces on top. Borger serving here in the opening set. Lady Bulldogs will be Bridges.
You gotta love it when you can run a fast offense off the service receive. Kendall loves to take that quick set in the middle.
Whitefaces now with Fletcher back to serve at 5-2 in the opening set. Fletcher with a good service. Borger back deep, near side. Down the line, passed back over by the Whitefaces, tipped over. Played up by Baker, bumped up. Off the net now, that's Vallejo. Back near side, blocked by the Whitefaces. Blair up there along with Grajeda. And it's a Whiteface point, 6-2. That was pretty impressive there.
Nice.
Hereford serves, Borger. Back row attack, played up by Fletcher. Baker passes near side. Blair rolls it over and down. Blair with three quick kills, 7-2 Hereford.
Second time Kendall Blair has been able to just kind of tool off the outside blocker.
7-2 Hereford. Whiteface is off and running here in their second district game. Deep serve, Borger near side, bump deep, Fletcher tied on the net. Baker plays it up and over. Oh my goodness, hit the antenna, but a great play by Blair and Baker to get that thing back in play. But a point for Borger, 7-3. Borger serving now as Pena will be the server at 7-3 here in the opening set. Whiteface is ready to receive. Aho along with Grajeda. Not a great pass here. We'll just have to kind of get this from across, right across the top of the net. Borger passes back tight on the net. Big swing, blocked, played up. We got in the net. 7-4. Borger now with a little more size on the floor as they've got Bridges. Bridges, who's just a freshman, is on the net. 7-4. Whitefaces lead the opening set. Borger is serving. Pena is the server. And here we go. Cuts it over. We play it tight.
Nice.
And there is Blair off the block. Her fourth kill. The Whitefaces lead it 8-4.
Pretty pass, pretty set. Put it away. Nice.
Madrigal in to serve now. The junior back at the service line. On the back row with Trevino. Good serve and a good pass by Borger. Far side, blocked by the Whitefaces. Borger. Ooh. Borger gets it across. Played up Ramirez to Madrigal. Over to Baker. Baker down the line. Baker with a kill. And the Whitefaces lead it 9-4. Timeout. Borger. We're back in 60 seconds.
Hereford ISD is now accepting referrals for students who may need gifted and talented services for the school year. This program is designed for students who exhibit intellectual and creative thinking abilities at an extraordinary level not normally served in the regular classroom. Services are provided only upon identification of education needs of the student. Anyone wishing to refer a student attending Hereford ISD in 1st through 12th grade this school year is asked to go by the student's campus office and request a copy of their referral form. This form must be returned to the school by September 30th. Those unable to go by the school should call the student's home campus to request a form be sent to them.
The community of Hereford continues to be committed to the Hereford Whitefaces, just as Happy State Bank is committed to our customers. Perseverance, commitment, and resilience are key ingredients for success both on and off the field of play. Whether you are cheering on the Hereford Whitefaces, starting a business, or planning for the future, Happy State Bank is here for all your life's moments. Let us be your partner at Happy State Bank. Visit us in person or at happybank.com. Happy State Bank, a division of Centennial Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
And as we return to play, Hereford serve, Borger in the net, makes it 10-4 Whitefaces. They had a little something there, but the hitter got in the net. So Madrigal serves again. That one's way out. And our second service error makes it 10-5 Hereford here in the opening set. For Borger now, they've got Buchanan back at the service line. Buchanan, a senior, serves it to Trevino. Over it goes to Blair, and Blair, Blair down the line gets her fifth kill.
Yep, she was off the net just a little bit, took a little speed off the ball and caught the blocker on her way down.
Blair with the ankle brace on her left ankle. She was injured back earlier in the year. Kind of a precaution now, I would imagine. Cross court, great dig by the Whitefaces. Baker bumps it up, alley up high. Big swing and long. 11-6. Alley just missed a little bit long, but again, she's been a real big force for the Whitefaces. She, too, is wearing an ankle bracelet on her left ankle. Ankle brace, I should say. There's a service error by Borger, and it is 11-6 Hereford. 12-6 Hereford. So we used to wear those, Coach. I mean, something similar to that all the time, right?
Yes, after a practice before the state tournament, the last practice that we had one of our kids go under the net, and a hitter came down, stepped on that kid, and tore up an ankle, and we invested heavily in ankle braces for quite some time.
Villarreal ready to serve. She really came on last year for the Whitefaces, played some good defense, good back row. We've got some question here about the rotation or something, so the officials at the score book. 12-6, the Whitefaces lead. Everything's okay. We're ready to play. Little jump serve, floater. Borger passes it tight on the net. Big swing, great dig by the Whitefaces. Can we get it across?
Get it over.
They do. Great save by Blair. Played up. Back it goes to Baker. Baker with a big hit. Borger gets it back. Borger gets it across. Played up by Blair. Pass to Madrigal. Here it comes to Alley. Alley with a kill. Priscilla's second kill. The Whitefaces lead it 13-6. That was a great save in the middle of that rally.
It was good defense by the Lady Whitefaces. Mean.
Here we go. Villarreal serves. Deep middle. Borger. Not a great pass here.
Out.
And we can't They play it, probably shouldn't have played it. Villarreal was backing up near the line, and the ball went right through her fingertips, and it's 13-7 Hereford. We've served around once, so Quinones, who started the match, is back at the service line for the Lady Bulldogs. To Villarreal. Not a great pass, but we get it over to Baker. Baker cross court, dug up by Borger. Pass far side. Blocked by the Whitefaces. That was Baker with the block. Wow.
That was a perfect stuff right
It
there.
Was.
It went straight down on the laces.
Baker now serving with a big smile on her face. Her team leading 14-7 here in the opening set. In the middle, Borger rolls it over. Allie plays it up. Back it goes now behind the line. Just wide. Blair tried to set her back behind the 10-foot line, and she cut it a little too short. 14-8, Hereford by 6. Borger serving. For the Lady Bulldogs now, it's Pettit. Pettit to serve. Hereford by 6, opening set. Pettit, good serve. We have to dive, but we get it. Pass it over the far side and through the block. There's Allie with her third kill. And the Whitefaces lead it 15-8. Allie out. Back in comes Solarzano. Whitefaces with Vallejo, along with Fletcher and Blair on that front line at the moment. Good serve. Good pass. Borger, we tipped it and don't. Kind of got a little confused there on the back line. Didn't go for it. And it's Borger's point. We got a hand on it up on the net. Slowed it a little bit, but kind of added confusion, I think, to us. 15-9, Whitefaces lead. Borger serving. Bridges the serve. Nice pass by Villarreal. In the middle now. Blair straight down. Blair's sixth kill. Whitefaces lead it by 7.
That's that same play. Quick set out of the middle. Serve receive.
Whitefaces now sub back in Grajeda, the sophomore. Up on the net with Blair and Vallejo. Near side. Rolled over. Nice dig by the Whitefaces. In the middle now. Tipped over. Great play. Nice play by Samantha.
Sam took a good look at where there was an opening. That little delay tip. Nobody home.
17-9. Whitefaces lead. We'll take a 30-second break, Daniel, and be right back.
The brightest star in the Lone Star State. Stevens 5-star car and truck center. One price selling makes it easy to buy. You get 5-star treatment, we treat you great. We're stars and great selection. The quality and value too. Stevens does it all for you. You get 5-star treatment every day.
Stevens 5-star car and truck center.
All right, 17-9. Whitefaces lead the opening set here against the Bulldogs of Borger. Crowd, great crowd, enjoying the action thus far. Whitefaces have Fletcher serving. Younger sister of Jaden. Jaden's off making his way at Texas Tech, I believe. Oops, into the net. Third service error of the match, 17-10, Whitefaces. Whitefaces bring Trevino back in. Charisma is a junior, ready to receive serve now from Borger's Pena. Good service, good pass. In the middle, Blair throws it down. They play it back. Blocked by the Whitefaces on the net. Now Borger back near side, tips it over, played up by Blair. Back to Blair. Blair with a big swing, Borger with a nice dig. Borger back in play. Blocked by the Whitefaces, Grajeda, and that's a point for the Whitefaces. Great play. Single block by Samantha. Wow.
11-22, am I right? Go ahead.
18-10. That was pretty big league stuff there.
That was good. At first, I didn't know if it crossed or not, but by golly, I think it
did. Yeah, I believe it did. Good service by the Whitefaces. Lady Bulldogs, near side. Blocked by the Whitefaces. Blair up there again, sky high. I don't know if Grajeda got a part of it or not, but she might have. 19-10, it's a Whiteface point. Madrigal serve, good service. Borger, far side, big swing. We get a block on it. Blair plays it up.
set far side. Nice set to Baker. They get a block on Irma. Can't play it. Baker gets her second kill, and it's 20-10, Whitefaces.
Good little run here. I don't want to jinx anything, but we were needing a little run.
Yep, Whitefaces by 10. Again, Madrigal with a nice service. Borger near side, mishit, and because it was, we can't get to it. Unfortunate turn of events there, but it's a point for Borger. 20-11, the Whitefaces lead, and for the Bulldogs, it'll be Buchanan back to serve. Good pass by London. Back to London, off the net here. And Borger in the net, 21-11. I think it was going to be a kill anyway, but Whiteface point.
Purcell. One of those you might just fudge a little bit.
Yeah,
the stat
we'll go ahead.
There
yeah,
you
we'll go.
Go
ahead. Yeah, well, I might as well. Here we go. Blair serving at 21-11 Hereford. Deep. Pass back to the middle by Borger, set near side. Cross court, Blair digs it up. Baker sets it. Purcell swings. They block it. Hereford plays it up and can't keep it alive. Good job by Trevino to get a fist on it, but we just couldn't get it back playable. 21-12. Borger trails by 9 as they make a sub here and bring Tarango in to serve. First time we've seen Tarango on the floor here tonight. She serves with her club trailing 21-12. Service back to Trevino, near side Purcell. Cross court, Borger with a nice dig. In the middle, they push it across. Baker plays it up. Set near side, Purcell off the net, rolls it across. Played up by Borger, far side, tip back. Nice save by Borger. Dumped over, played back by Borger. Oh. That's a lift, that's a point for the Whitefaces. Good job by Madrigal there. She caught him napping. And the Whitefaces lead it 22-12. All right, Whitefaces now with Fletcher and Baker and Purcell and Madrigal, Blair, and Villarreal. Villarreal serves near side. 22-12, Hereford. Bumped across, played up by Blair. Set far side, Baker. Baker down the line and in. 23-12, four kills for London.
What success she is having hitting down the line this evening. Good spot.
23-12, Villarreal serves. Whitefaces 2 points away from winning the opening set. Blocked, but falls on Hereford's side. Purcell turns around to Coach McCracken immediately and makes the gesture of what I should have done. 23-13. Some of those are going to happen, though. You're going to get some where you just don't get it back across the net. Quinones serves. Hereford by 10 in the opening set. Quinones to Baker, to Madrigal, to Purcell. And again, Borger with a nice dig. But they can't get it back across, and it's 24-13. Whitefaces need a point to go up one here. Whitefaces need a sub here. Lexi forgot she was going in. London serves now for the opening set. Borger now with some, I don't know what, kind of question for the official.
I think they had a question on whether the hit the antenna or not.
Oh, it did, but wasn't called. Baker with a good serve. Borger across. Baker. Villarreal off the net. Alley just bumps it across. Played up by Borger. Dumped. Nice save by the Whitefaces. Solarizano. Fletcher with a big swing, but dug up by Borger again. Borger's kind of settled in. Played better here as we've gone along. Baker in the middle of Purcell. That's it. Purcell puts it away with her fourth kill, and the Whitefaces win the opener 25-13 over the Bulldogs. So we'll take ourselves a minute, 30-second break. Be back here at Whiteface Gym in a minute and a half.
Whatever your type of home, experience a new level of home comfort with the new Bryant Evolution system. When installed with the Evolution Connects control, this advanced system can communicate with both your indoor and outdoor units for increased comfort and efficiency. Ask your Bryant dealer about an Evolution heating and cooling system today.
Call Bob's Heating and Air at 364-1195, your local factory-authorized Bryant dealer.
With summer coming to an end, First National Bank of Hereford and Friona Banking Center want to wish the faculty and students a fantastic school year. Best wishes from your only locally owned bank. We have roots where others have branches. First National Bank of Hereford and Friona Banking Center. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lenders, NMLS number 631622.
Texas Farm Bureau Insurance has protected fellow Texans with auto, home, health, and life insurance since 1952. With more than 260,000 square miles of land and 27 million people, that's a lot to cover. Whether you're wrangling cattle or wrangling kids, we're proud to protect Texans and all Texan ways of life.
Call DeVsmith County Farm Bureau at 806-364-1070 to speak with an agent today.
Coverage and discounts are subject to qualifications and policy terms and may vary by situation.
All right, back here at Whiteface Gym, Hereford up one over Borger as we get set for the second set. Whiteface is gathered now down to our left around Coach McCracken. And again, great crowd here at the gym tonight. Of course, all the parents for the Whitefaces all gathered over there together to protect each other from any of the slings and arrows that may come their way. Or maybe, I don't know, maybe they want Deanne over there so they can hear her clearly.
I think Deanne can be heard clearly anywhere she is
really?
In the gym. I do.
I don't know.
She's got that principal / coach voice, you know.
That's good. Well, the Whitefaces, again, on the road Saturday at Pampa. Then I believe Dumas is here next Tuesday night, and then we play the Three Canyons in a row. So, no easy nights in volleyball for anybody. Borger back out there for set number two, the Whitefaces with Priscilla and Fletcher. And now this time, Cambry Smith, the junior, up on the front line with Baker serving. And then the freshman, Thomas, out on the floor along with Cameron Blair. Got to be... First time on the home court in district for Tegan. Got to be kind of a butterfly sort of night, huh?
No kidding. It's rough to be a freshman on the varsity,
yep.
too.
Woo! Yep. All right, here we go. Whiteface is serving up one here at Whiteface Gym. It's service by Baker. Passed back over. Up high goes Priscilla, and down it goes. And just like that, it's 1-0. Little overpass, and Allie didn't waste any time with it.
I think she'd take those all night long.
I think so. Give them to her. Well, Allie, I can't tell y'all. I mean, here's Baker with the serve. I'll tell you later. Good pass, near side, off the top of the net, dug up by Thomas. Pass far side over to Allie. Through the block again. Whitefaces lead it 2-0. That's 6 for her, 6 for Blair, and 4 for Baker. In the killed category here tonight. And Baker serves at 2-0 Hereford. London, good serve, far side, just wide. Again, she tried to cut that thing, and it's an impossible serve almost to return if you get it in. We did 2-1. Borger serving here at the line for the Lady Bulldogs is Pettit. Good service. Blair with a nice dig. Near side up high, through the block. Priscilla once again. Well, Allie's hot. Give it to her.
She's coming out,
Dad. Oh, no. Yeah, we're taking her out. Golly, bum. So in comes Solarizano now. 7 kills for Priscilla as she goes to the sideline. Solarizano with a nice serve. Borger off the net. Dug up by Solarizano. Passed over to Blair. Blair hits it long. 3-2. Cameron's about 4 or 5 feet off the net, just didn't quite get on top of that one like she wanted to. Point for Borger. Bridges now serves for the Lady Bulldogs. They trail 3-2 here at Whiteface Gym. Good service, Blair to Baker, near side now to Fletcher through the block. Good job by Janae, her first kill of the night. 4-2 Hereford.
Borger defense leaves a big spot in the middle of the floor, yep, for a soft roll shot. Hurd needs that.
Yep. Fletcher with a good service. Borger with a good pass. Quinones, far side. Hurford plays it up. Great save by the Whitefaces. Across by Solarzano. Borger back in the middle now. And through the block this time. Smith got up there but couldn't get it blocked. And it's 4-3, Hurford.
Didn't quite have a good seal on the net that yep. time. Is able to roll down the front of us.
So for Borger, it's Pena in to serve. 4-3. 1 point Hurford lead here in the second set. Great serve. Solarzano didn't get it up. And that's the first service ace of the match. 4-4 now in the second set. Borger getting a little momentum going here as the Bulldogs serve to Solarzano. Not a good pass. We get it across, but it's out. 5-4.
This is kind of the bugaboo that the Lady Whitefaces have faced much of the season. Things are rolling along really, really well, and then they kind of yep. dip down south for a while.
Couple of serves here that have really hurt us. Now a good pass this time, and Blair hits it wide. We had what we wanted, and Cameron just hooked it a little bit. Now it's 6-4 Borger here in the second set. The Bulldogs getting some life here. Pena with another good serve. Good pass by Trevino. Dumped over, played right back, played right back. And now on Hereford's side in the middle, blocked by Borger. Played back up, far side to Blair, cross court. Borger gets a fist on it, gets it back up, and free balls it over. Whitefaces, Trevino plays it, pass it over to Blair up high. They block it. It's up for the net, and Borger blocked by the Whitefaces. What a point here. Borger far side off the top of the net. Blair plays it up. Baker sets Blair. Blair goes deep, and it's a point for the Whitefaces, and a hard-earned one. Seventh kill for Blair.
Lots of good play on both sides of the net that time.
There was.
Offensively and defensively.
You can see Borger's gotten a little confidence as mm-hmm. this thing's gone along. 6-5 Hereford. Served by Madrigal. Borger. Far side. Blocked by the Whitefaces. Bulldogs cross. Great diving save by Solarzano. Over it goes. And, oh, Borger plays one that's out and then hits it across. And we can't play it back. Well, the Bulldogs.
Their tallest player just yep. had just jumped straight up, reached straight up, cut that thing down.
And she is a freshman, I might add. 7-5, Borger in the second set. Serve back deep. Solarzano, near side now, Blair. Down the line, Blair puts it in. She gets her eighth, and it's 7-6, Borger. Back now is Blair. Kendall serving. Whitefaces trail by a point. Won the opening set. Kendall with a good service, but a good pass by Borger. Near side. That's out, and the Whitefaces tied up at 7. Bulldogs that time got a little excited, I think, at the line, at the net. Pettit hit it way long. 7-all. Again, we're in the second set. Kendall serves near side. Borger. Pena. Thrown over.
Oh.
Yep. Picked up. Hereford sets Blair. Blair to the middle. Great dig by Borger. Back over. Can't get it over. Point for the Whitefaces.
That would have really been dangerous if she had gotten that
yep.
thing to fall on the other side of the net. It was just...
She made Pettit, made a great play to get it even close. Blair serves now. Borger to Pena. And again,
oh.
thrown
oh.
over. My goodness. 8-all. Wow.
Wow.
I don't know what you got to do to get a throw, but we've had a couple of them right quickly here, and neither one's called. Borger serving, 8-all, second set. Bulldog service comes to Ramirez. Played back over to Priscilla off the top of the net. Borger plays it back over to Baker. They block Baker. Baker dumps it over. Borger gets to it. Baker
Good
with a
spot.
Kill. Great job by London there to kind of just change the tempo, 9-8. Whitefaces by 1, and Thomas in to serve now. Freshman serving. Jumps and serves. Good service, Borger. Near side. Down the line and out. Point for the Whitefaces, 10-8. Whitefaces by 2 now as Borger's made a couple of errors. And Thomas serves again. Jumps and serves. Good service. Wow. Borger, not a good pass. This one, they'll just have to free ball over. We block it. Nice play by Fletcher and Baker. And the Whitefaces go up by three. Timeout, Borger. We're back in 30 seconds.
Did you know that every internet-connected device poses a risk to your home network? Protect IQ from WTRT and WT Services provides an extra layer of protection by blocking viruses, malware, and malicious attacks. It even works on devices such as smart thermostats and video doorbells. Protect your home today by adding Protect IQ to your internet service plan. Don't have the WT Smart Home app? Download it in app stores today.
Well, Hereford's turned a two-point deficit into a three-point lead here, and Borger takes a timeout. Really, we've just played pretty good volleyball here the last few points.
Yep, we have. Had a little bit of a downturn, started that second set, but Lady Whitefaces have kind of regrouped, and we need to keep the pressure on Borger right now.
For
again,
sure.
Center of the court for Borger is wide open. We have got to keep rolling it in there.
Good serve. Great serve by Thomas. It's an ace. Wow. Last year you were playing now where? In the eighth grade, huh? 12-8 Whitefaces. That's always been amazing to me. Good serve again, Borger to Pena, far side. Hereford gets it up. Nice play by Thomas there. Pass it over to Alley. Big swing to the middle. Whitefaces get the point. 13-8. Alley's got eight. Again, Thomas, we've had a great run with her at the service line here. Ready once again. Jumps and serves. Near side. The back line. Another ace. Wow. 14-8. Whitefaces by six. Again, Tegan ready. Too deep this time. 14-9 as Thomas hits it long. That's her fifth servicer of the match. But I think Tegan went to the line. We were down 8-9, and we're up 14-9. So not a bad run.
Here, we'll take it from a freshman.
We will from a freshman. 14-9. Service comes to Thomas. Pass on the net. Dumped over by the Whitefaces. Borger gets to it at the net. Can't get it across. Point for the Whitefaces. 15-9. Good job by Madrigal there. She didn't quite probably get it exactly where she wanted to, but got them out of sync, and it's a Whiteface point. Again comes, nope, Smith's not coming back in. Just kidding. Jump serve by Baker. Borger, near side. Top of the net and falls on Hereford's side, 15-10. Good hit by Borger's Cooper Buchanan, the junior with the point, and it's 15-10 Hereford, and back to serve is Pettit. Pettit from mid-floor, good service, and the Whitefaces
chased it
down. Nice save by Hereford to get it back in play. Borger's got a free ball here, though, in the middle. They'll throw it across. Hereford plays it up. Baker back, and the Whitefaces to the middle of the floor. That is Blair, as Coach mentioned. That's 10 for Blair, 16-10 Hereford. Nobody home as Solarizano in to serve.
Borger not expecting that back row attack.
Good job by Solarizano, but Borger with a chance here. We get a block on it. Played up by Solarizano. Dumped over to the far side. They block Blair. Point for the Bulldogs. Good job by Borger that time. The block by Bridges. And it's 16-11, Hereford. That's what Borger has. They've done a better job blocking as we played along here. Here is Bridges to serve. Back to Blair, to Baker. In the middle, oh my goodness. 11 kills for Blair. That time, I'm telling you, she just sailed through the air.
That rotation, Borger has not figured out a way to get a block up against her.
17-11, it's just such a, I mean.
Pretty, isn't it?
It is such a pretty, ace by Fletcher. Yeah, when you just can jump, I mean, run like that and jump and then swing all in one, it's just, it's a very, very pretty thing. 18-11. Fletcher to the middle. Borger, far side. Hereford digs it up, plays it back over. Comes to Blair. Blair with a kill. She's got a dozen. The Whitefaces lead at 19-11.
Borger middle blocker late getting across to the block, and so Blair used it, hit down the front of her.
Fletcher serves, Borger. Quinones rushes. Blocked by the Whitefaces. Nope, didn't get across. Point for the Whitefaces, 20-11. That time Bridges just got it up the top of the net cord, didn't get across. Fletcher serves again. Borger hustles to it, bumps it across, chance to score. Baker, Solarizano, Baker, not much on that one. Borger digs it up, near side, Borger, partially blocked. The Whitefaces dig it up, and Herford gets it across, and it's a point. Solarizano.
Gonna get a kill in the stand.
I mean,
tonight.
A kill for her, and 21-11, Herford, timeout, Borger, back in 30 seconds.
Did you know that all prepaid funeral plans are transferable? If you purchased a prepaid funeral plan through another funeral home, you are not in any way obligated to use that funeral home in your time of need. The Texas Department of Banking and the Texas Department of Insurance allow individuals to change funeral homes and use a funeral home of their choice. Allow Mendez and Mullins Family Funeral Home and our licensed funeral directors to explain the easy process of transferring your funeral plan. Hereford's only family-owned and operated funeral home. Our family serving your family.
Well, across the way, I just looked up and saw my old buddy Bob Baker, and he's in the London Baker cheering section along with Cindy. But Dr. Baker is also up there. That would be Dr. Lauren Baker. Not too long ago.
You have to specify.
I know.
You have to identify which it is.
Dr. Teresa Baker is watching Emerald High play somebody. I don't know who, but somebody. 21-11. Ellen happens to be a sophomore member of the Sandy squad. Fletcher serves, 21-11 Herford. Lady Dogs play it to the near side. Big swing and through the block. Smith got up, got a hand on it, but Bridges, the freshman, with the kill. 21-12. Bridges is going to be, she's going to be a player. Here is served by Borger back to Solarizano in the middle to a block on Blair. Herford back just free balls it over. Borger now with a chance to score here. Far side, Borger hits it out. Point for the Whitefaces, 22-12.
Trying to cut it so sharp.
And, she was. She was a foot off the net, tried to hit it a foot across, and that didn't work. All right, here we go. Madrigal serves at 22-12. Good service. Borger, far side. Dug up on the backside by Solarizano. Pass back near to Baker. Baker down the line. Great dig by Borger that time to get it up, but they can't get it across. So it is 23-12. Herford now 2 points away from going up too low over the Bulldogs. Again, Madrigal serves near side. Lady Dogs with a couple of lifts there, and then they hit it out. And it's 24-12. One away now. Maddie goes back to serve. 24-12, Herford. Good service. They play it. The back line. Scramble for it. Can't get it across. It's an ace, and that ends it. Herford wins set number two, 25-12, goes up to love. We'll take a minute, 30-second break and be back at Whiteface Gym.
Herd athletes work tirelessly on the fundamentals of their particular sport while learning to work in a team concept. It's not much different at Herford Texas Federal Credit Union. Our employees have a dedication to serve our members daily with the fundamentals of good business. Being friendly and helping give you peace of mind and knowing that when you need banking assistance, you can get it from our knowledgeable staff. Herford Texas Federal Credit Union, member NCUA, working as a team since 1936 with our members. Go Herd.
Hey you, yeah you. You should be watching or listening to the game in style with a new sectional, sofa, love seat, and or recliner from Herford Furniture Exchange. Check out the huge selection of new brand name furniture, mattresses, appliances, and electronics at Herford Furniture Exchange, 209 East Park Avenue in Herford. They're open 7 days a week. Financing options available with no credit needed and an initial payment as low as $10. Merchandise is in stock. Buy today, take home today. Herford Furniture Exchange.
When the unthinkable happens, good neighbors show up. For 100 years, State Farm has been among the first to arrive with the latest technology and tools to help you recover faster. State Farm has been there before, and they'll be there again and again. Stop by and see your local State Farm insurance agent, Matt Silva, at 801 Main Street in Hereford. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
All right, welcome back to the gym. Hereford up 2-0 over the visitors from Borger. 13-12 the scores in the first two. Lady Whiteface is really playing some pretty good volleyball. Again, Borger is not a bad volleyball team.
No, they're not a bad volleyball team. They've had a little run there in that second set. And it seems though that they just can't maintain it. They get a little cautious and they get a little tentative. Once they start scoring a few, they kind of pull back just a little bit, and I'm afraid they'll grow past that.
Yeah. Steve Purcella sitting over there. I bet he knows a lot about volleyball, don't you? The old bulldogger himself. Or actually, he was a roper. But the Whitefaces lead by a 2-0 score. And again, it's been a dozen for Kendall and 8 for Alley, 6 for London. We've had about 6 or 7 blocks and 4 aces. Maddie with 1 there to end that one, Maddie Madrigal. Tegan Thomas had a couple, and Janae Fletcher had 1. So the Whitefaces now with Fletcher and Madrigal, Purcella and Baker, and Villarreal and Blair, the 6 on the floor.
Good test right now for the Lady Whitefaces. Won the first two in pretty decisive fashion. So can you get out here now and play hard and get a run going in this third set?
Alex Shepard, who's the tallest of the Lady Bulldogs, is now starting here in this third set in the middle. So we'll see what that does for them, if anything. Whiteface is ready to receive serve. Again, have won the first two with some good volleyball. Borger, it'll be Pena, who's one of their setters. She will serve to begin this third set. She's ready. The officials are ready, and here we go. Pena serves. Good pass, Madrigal to Madrigal. Baker off the top of the net. Gets the kill. Got the roll down the net, and it's 1-0 Hereford.
Shout out to Mr. Hedrick. He has had a medical procedure done, and he's at home, I'm sure, listening, and it is probably killing him not being
here. London serves, dumped over by Borger, back near side to Purcella, through the block. 9 for Alley. Adam's having to do all the photography work
Double duty.
Again tonight.
Anastasia's up there, too.
She's up there working away,
She was a little
Here's the overpass. Oh, my goodness. The serve was overpassed, and Purcella nearly took someone's head off.
Allie had one of those first rounds out of the box in the second set, didn't she?
3-0 Hereford now. Whiteface football coaches wander in over there across the way. Near side, Borger blocked by the Whitefaces and can't get it back up. 3-1, Whitefaces lead in the third set, up 2-0. Coach Naren over there, Coach Garza, Service is out. Nope, it's in. We let it sail. We thought it was wide, and official said it wasn't, so it's 3-2 now. Service ace by Borger's Katie Buchanan. Buchanan serves again. Nice pass this time. In the middle now, Blair. Blair, they dig her up, play it back to the Borger's back line, just bump it across. Now Baker with a chance in the middle. She sets Fletcher, and Fletcher on the quick hit puts it down, gets her second kill, and it's 4-2 Hereford. Solarzano back in to serve. Villarreal, Baker, Blair, Alvarado, and Fletcher. At the net, Blair up to tip it down. That's 13 for her, and it's 5-2 Hereford. Boy, Blair can jump, can't she? My goodness.
She can.
5-2, Herford. Serve is deep middle. Borger, not a great pass, scrambling to get it over. They do. We get it up. Nice save by the Whitefaces. Borger back near the net, and they can't get it across. Oops, Herford went across
man.
The net. Did we? 5-3.
We went across, but I thought she was trying to hit it across.
Yep. I don't know. 5-3. Borger gets the point. A pained look on Coach McCracken's face. I don't.
She was trying. She put up a fist to hit it across, and so that's a blockable ball.
Service comes to Solarzano, back near side to Blair. Blair with a nice throw down the line, but they play it up. They buff it across. Nice save by the Whitefaces. Blair up high. My goodness gracious. 14 kills for her. 6-3 Herford. That one was straight down. I'm telling you, she's 3 feet above the net. Wow. Fletcher serves at 6-3 Herford here in the third. Good serve. Borger, far side. Blocked by the Whitefaces and point to the Whitefaces. That was Grajeda again. She's kind of found her little spot there, too, the sophomore. She's a great, great athlete, great leaper. Here's the serve. It's Borger almost didn't get it back up there. It's hit across by Borger, played up. Baker sets Blair. Blair again. That was real tight. I mean, she had to really make a move to stay out of the net. 8-3 Herford, timeout Borger, back in 30 seconds.
Good start.
Oh, there's nothing like the sound of a new baby calf or the smell of fresh rain on a cotton crop. My friends at Capital Farm Credit share this excitement with agricultural and livestock producers. We want to be your lending partner. Whether you require operating funds for next year's crop or need to buy hay for your cattle, we have a loan that's right for you. Let us finance your operation. CapitalFarmCredit.com.
All right, back here at Whiteface Gym, it's 8-3 Herford in the third set. Borger taking a timeout. Whiteface is really, really playing some good volleyball at the moment. Fletcher to serve now. Fletcher, Solarzano, Baker, Blair, Alvarado, and Grajeda out on the floor for the Whitefaces. We've won by scores of 12 and 13. Fletcher serves. Borger sets. Baker, Solarzano, off the net now. Blair, big swing, great dig by Borger. They lift it, point for the Whitefaces. Well, I'll tell you, Blair, I mean, that time, that wasn't a great set or anything, but she made something out of it. Nice serve here by Fletcher. Borger, we got a block on it, dug up by Solarzano. Baker, near side, again Blair, down the line, and that is 17. 17 kills for Blair. 10-3 Whitefaces. Wow. Can't teach that. Fletcher deep. They play it. Not well. Near side. Across and out. And it's 11-3. Whitefaces now got them on the run. Not going to ease off. Travis Johnson's here tonight. That's a shocker, isn't it? Borger throws it over. Nice play by Fletcher. Set near side to Blair, and this time she hung a little too long in the air and hit it long. 11-4. I guess we'll excuse that one. Since she's had 17 kills. 11-4 Herford. Pena serves for Borger. Good pass by Solarzano. Blair out of the middle, right in the face.
Yep.
Whitefaces pouring it on now as Madrigal comes in, Alvarado comes out. Maddie will serve now with Trevino and Solarzano on the back row. Baker, Grajeda, and Blair up front. Borger a little confused about their alignment. 12-4 Herford. Might face student body. Pretty vocal over there. I don't know what's going on, but just cheering, nothing rap, nothing bad. 12-4. Maddie ready. Good service. Far side, bumped over by Borger, played up by Madrigal, near side Blair, and she hit it long. 12-5, Whitefaces by 7. Travis is talking to Coach Naron over there. I don't know if he's giving him some ideas for Friday night or what. 12-5, Whiteface footballers again, 3-0, playing on Friday night against Tascosa. Baker to Madrigal, who dumps it to the middle, and Borger can't get to it. Second time tonight now, Maddie's had that made that play. 13-5, Hereford, Blair to serve. We're in the third set for a big crowd here at Whiteface Gym. Whiteface is having their way. Serve is wide. Blair tried to cut it over here to the near line. We've done that about 3 times tonight. I mean, it's a good idea. Borger now serving at 13-6 here in the third set. This is the freshman. Good service. Hereford plays it up, and Hereford lifts it. 13-7. Madrigal that time had it, just got it a little too far down in the hands and can't do that. So it's a 6-point match now as Borger serves. 13-7. Guess we've got, I don't know what we've got. The official on the net has walked over.
Well, flash photography.
Oh, flash photography, okay. So they've got that squared away. No more flash photography. Hereford by 6, Borger serving. Third set, good service. Oh. Alley off the net, and Alley gets it down. Good job by Purcella to make it 14-7, Hereford. Back in now comes Villarreal to serve for the Lady Whitefaces. Leading by 7 in the third set. Little jump serve floater. Not a great pass by the Lady Bulldogs. They'll just get it across. Here we go. In the middle, Baker. They block it. Block it out. Point for the Whitefaces. Baker's got 8 kills. Whitefaces lead 15-7. Villarreal ready again. Good service. Ooh. They got it across. Hereford has to score. Purcella, they block her. Played up by Baker, pushed over by the Whitefaces. Scrambling for it, they can't play it back. Point for the Whitefaces. Good job that time by Villarreal, I believe it was, who up on the net saw them creeping up and pushed it to the back line. Hereford by 9. Borger, near side. Oh, Borger got away with a lift. Wow, 16-8.
Ooh,
that's right.
That was a kill.
We can't say anything, but ooh, 16-8. Borger serving here in the third set. Whitefaces about to go 2-0 in the district, heading to Pampa on Friday night. Baker, Madrigal, Purcella just bumps it across. Borger bumps it back, but bumps it out. Point for the Whitefaces. 17-8. Coach Brown made a mental error there, and he was trying to get out of the way. He said 17-8 now. Whitefaces by 9. Baker serving. Good serve by London. Good pass by Borger. Again, Borger with a lift. That's the first time they've called that.
Yeah, you're right.
But they did call it that time. 18-8, Hereford. London ready again. Jump serve to the middle. Borger, good pass to the net. Great dig on the back line by Blair. Near side to Purcella. They block her. We play it right back up. Baker pushes it deep. Borger plays it from the far side. Borger gets cross. Hereford plays it back to Baker. Baker to Fletcher. Fletcher hits them right in the face, so they get it back and then hit it out. 19-8. Ref said it was in, 18-9. Okay. 18-9. Whitefaces by 9. Whiteface fans with a little bit of a boo there. To Blair, to Baker. Over to Purcella. Through the block, they play it up. Throw it back. He's called it again. 19-9. I mean, that's gone on all night.
I know.
Call twice. Herford needs six. Send them home. Borger protesting, but the protest should be about, I mean, should be thankful for all the times they've thrown it. It hasn't been called. 19-9. You know what it is. Let's play. Solarizano ready to serve. Little high floater that Borger bumps across. Back to Baker. Near side to Blair. Blair down the line. That is 19. We're in the third set now. There hadn't been anything. 19 kills, folks, is a ton. Solarizano serve. To the near side. Good serve. Borger just scrambling to get it back. Nice pass. Near side. Blair down the line. Across court. Number 20. 21.
She's hit so many down the line.
Yep.
That everybody's kind of shifted that way, and everybody was frozen solid when she hit cross court.
Including the guy broadcasting. 21-9. Solarizano near side again. Tight. So you give it over the far side. Now that's Alvarado. She can't get it across. It's 21-10. Just kind of got it off the back of her hand, and the Whitefaces lead by 11 as Borger serves here in the third set. Back to serve for the Lady Bulldogs is Savannah Padilla. Her serve, nice pass by the Whitefaces. Solarizano to Fletcher. Fletcher with her third kill of the night. 22-10.
Fletcher
now.
Up in Perryton. She hit quick set after quick set after quick set.
That's good. We need her going. Good serve here. Oh, really good serve. Borger pushes it over. Oh, we have to dive to get it, and we do. Borger then hits it on the second hit. That whole deal was out of sync. 22-11. Point for the Lady Bulldogs. Back in for Borger to serve now is Pena. Whiteface is three away from a 2-0 district record. Back to Pena in the middle to Blair. They dig Blair this time and play it back. Herford going to have to just free ball this one over. Blair does. Borger, good pass, near side.
Oh,
Borger with a lift. Borger, oh, Herford called in the net.
After a bad set.
22-12. Wow. Whitefaces by 10. Borger serving now. And the Whitefaces. Guess we thought that was long. We backed away. It was not. And it's 22-13. Pena serving again for the Lady Bulldogs here now. Whitefaces need three more points. Pena with the service. Solarizano to Baker. Baker to Blair. Blair into the net. 22-14. Blair may be arm weary after as many swings as she's taken tonight. Bulldogs down with Pena again. Whitefaces just need to finish this thing off right here and right now. Good pass, near side, Blair. They block Blair, but Herford plays it back up.
Reach.
Great play across by the Whitefaces. Borger on the far side. Nice dig by Solarizano. Dump by Baker. They get to it. Played up by Trevino. Baker sets Blair. Blair down the line. Number 21. 23-14, Herford. Madrigal in. Now the Whitefaces two away. Crowd ready for this thing to come to an end. Maddie serves. Borger sets in the middle. Blocked by the Whitefaces. Played right back up. Back it goes. Cross court over now by Madrigal. Borger near side. Cross blocked by the Whitefaces. Pushed back by Grajeda, but Borger plays it back. Borger cross court through the block. 23-15. Whitefaces still two away. Bulldogs ready to serve. Whiteface student body again with the America t-shirts on. The service. Baker, miss hit. We get it across. Great save. And Borger misplays it. They get it back. Now the Whitefaces need to score right here, guys. Blair, they get a block on her. Can't play it. Yeah. Blair's 22nd. Makes it 24-15. Alley back in. Blair to serve. Whitefaces a point away from a sweep over the Lady Bulldogs. Blair, deep serve. Borger, far side. Big swing. Blocked by the Whitefaces. Played up. Over to Baker. Baker down the line. Dug up by the Bulldogs. But they get to it and get it across. Great save by Borger. Set near side alley. Off the top of the net. Point for Borger. 24-15. Good hustle by the Bulldogs as they battle here to the final point as the Bulldogs serve at 24-16. For Borger, it will be Bridges to serve now. Her service, Whitefaces to Baker. Baker off the top of the net. Borger, another great defensive save. Cross court, Herford plays it. And it's 24-17. That was way out, but we went up and played it. And so the Bulldogs now trail by seven, 24-17, as Bridges ready to serve again. We'll have some teaching points here because we haven't finished this thing off very well. Here's Baker. They block Baker. We play it back up. Blair in the back corner, a fitting ending, her 23rd kill. And the Whitefaces win this one 25-17 behind a great performance by Kendall Blair, among others.
Yeah, great offensive performance, and she does a lot for us in the backcourt as well.
Whiteface faithful starting to file out again. A great, great number in the student body section tonight, and they were cheering hard for the ladies in maroon and white. Well, Borger looked good warming up. They played well at times, but the Whitefaces played some good volleyball.
Yep, they did, and that's the thing that you always get a little nervous about is are we going to handle things well? And Lady Whitefaces coach couldn't ask for much more. Again, a few little teaching points
at the end.
Good job overall.
13, 12, and 17 the scores as the Whitefaces win. Charlie. So the Whitefaces 2-0 now in the district. Let's take a 60-second break. We'll visit with Coach McCracken in 1 minute.
Start here.
AC.
Go anywhere. Amarillo College is the place to prepare.
AC.
After serving my country in the military and a bout with colon cancer, I got a new start right here at Amarillo College. Great programs, great faculty. Start here. Go anywhere.
Trust your future to a college that cares.
Start here.
AC.
Go anywhere.
Your business, farm, or ranch and home is unique, and success depends in part on a cost-effective and convenient supply of quality fuel. When you trust your fueling needs to Gooden Fuels, it's one less detail for you to manage. Commercial fuel in bulk, delivered to your above or below ground tank, serving the Western Texas Panhandle with gasoline, diesel, and propane. Gooden Fuels in Hereford at 806-364-3366. Call them today to discuss your fuel needs.
Winning here, we've got a prayer at this moment. I'm sorry, we just came back on the air about that time. But they've taken care of that. The two teams, just the Whitefaces, I guess, out there for the prayer. 13, 12, and 17. Now you can say it again.
17, Tom, 17.
Too many in the last.
It was just, you can't be disappointed in that. It's just, as a coach, you want to see that score just go less and less,
Sure.
It was just ending the game, we let some silly errors get the best of us. So.
My stats aren't official, but they're not too far off generally, and I had Kendall with 23 kills.
Yes. I was just looking at our hitting efficiency, and our hits, our attackers were good today,
yep.
11
for Allie, 8 for Baker, and then 3 for Fletcher.
Yes.
So all across the board. I mean,
right, right. I think we've done a good job of kind of developing a spread offense, you know, where it'd be easy for people just to block our outsides, you know, but we've kind of made it balanced, and we've worked really hard at that.
Fletcher doing a good job of that quick offense in the middle, too.
Yes, yes. I mean, it's so much fun to see just how much she's improved and where we can go from here.
You know, I've talked about this before, and you probably with you, Coach, but I think the most enjoyable thing about me broadcasting is seeing how kids, I mean, like Allie Purcell, I mean, Allie has become a big-time volleyball player.
Right, right. That's what we always tell her, like, you got to be a dog, Allie. Yeah. Like, you know,
so. Well, she's a dog, all
she
right.
Is.
And, you know, they just played good defense. Tegan Thomas, we talked about her a little bit.
Yes.
Freshman stepping out there, and she had a nice run at the service.
Yes,
line.
She handled herself well, and I mean, they've all done everything that we can ask for.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, and I'm so proud of this group, and you know, we had a rough start to the season, but we design our preseason that way. You know, we want to play the big 5A, 6A schools, and we want to know well what our flaws are, and work on those as we get into district.
Now you go to Pampa on Saturday, and the Lady Harvesters, they gave us some trouble last year.
Right, yes. They have a big hitter, you know, and a big setter, too. So,
yeah.
I mean, it'll be – there's some big kids, you know.
Yeah.
We'll work on covering a lot.
We be back here next Tuesday night for Dumas, but the district, man, it's a tough row.
It really is. It is. But, you know, I mean, it's the way that our district – where we're ending with the, you know – West Plains, Randall Canyon, you know, I think that we kind of get our feet wet, you know, and then see those big dogs at the end. So.
This has been a little different kind of year for you. I mean, not as much experience coming back. And
right, right. You know, and I think, like, during our preseason, like I said, I mean, we play some tough teams, you know, and I think it's an eye-opener for those who haven't been up here, but they've handled themselves well, and we've responded well, and their work ethic in the gym is phenomenal, and so, I mean, that's all I can ask for.
I started to say, you can't ask for much more than that,
can you,
Coach? Well, congratulations tonight on the win, Coach.
Thank you.
Another great win, and we'll look forward to Saturday up in Pampa.
Yes, sir. All
right.
See you there.
Thank you, Carly.
Thank you.
Coach McCracken visiting with us here, and again, the Whiteface is winning 13, 12, and 17. Again, 23 kills for Kendall Blair, 11 for Priscilla. Allie and 8 for London, a couple of aces for Tegan Thomas, 1 for Fletcher, 1 for Madrigal, and the Whitefaces with a bunch of blocks. Grajeda had 3 blocks on the night, so that sophomore doing a good job defensively for the Whitefaces. And the bottom line is we win and we go to 2-0, and that's what we wanted to do. So we are glad you could join us. Our next time on the air will be Friday night when we're over at Dick Bivens for the meeting with Tascosa. Then Saturday we'll be back. We'll be playing at Pampa on Saturday afternoon in volleyball. And then back here next Tuesday night for volleyball against Dumas. So a lot happening in a hurry here. We're glad you could join us tonight. Appreciate you being along. For Coach Brenda Kitten, this is Tom Simon saying thanks for joining us. We'll see you Friday night with Whiteface Football.
This match is brought to you by First Financial Bank, Amarillo College, Gooden Fuels, First Bank Southwest, Prairie Insurance, Hereford Regional Medical Center, your Hereford McDonald's, Happy State Bank, Hereford Independent School District, Stevens 5-Star Car and Truck Center, First National Bank, Bob's Heating and Air, WT Services, Deaf Smith County Farm Bureau Insurance, Hereford Texas Federal Credit Union, Mendez and Mullins Family Funeral Home, Hereford Furniture Exchange, Capital Farm Credit, and Matt Silva State Farm Insurance.